guys. Thanks for tuning in. This is an interesting case where I previously placed one implant in the anterior and it failed. So I took that implant out, I grafted the area, let it heal, and now I'm coming back and raising a flap here. This is using a periosteal elevator just to elevate the soft tissue off of bone to expose the bone. And I want to retract it a little bit on the inside, which is called the lingual towards the tongue. And this is the lower jaw that you're looking at from above. Move that tissue back so we can see the surgical site. In between the two implants that you can see that are currently in place, we want to place two new implants. So this is just the pilot drill. Now I'm using the lingual bone on the inside to make sure that I'm parallel and straight and at the right angle, and preparing what the osteotomy. That's a fancy term for just drilling into the bone. Now that's a little guide pin that you can see that's going to help me make sure that I stay parallel in all three dimensions for the fourth and final implant. And I kind of started in this one spot. I'm like, nah, I think I'd rather be a little more anterior. So I created the osteotomy site. I'm checking my angles. Now that I have both sites drilled and the holes prepared in the bone, I can then go ahead and place the implant. Now I'm using like a little torque wrench after the initial handpiece. And I want you to note also that you can see that blue nasal hood. Basically, we're doing this under nitrous and local anesthetic. So the patient's awake and aware. This ratchet makes a little clicking noise, and we just kind of ratchet this into position and get both those implants in place. So now, if we retract the tissue on the inside, the bone is sticking up high. So I'm using the burr to reduce the vertical height of the bone on the inside or the tongue side, or what we call the lingual aspect. I put some generic metal discs on called healing abutments, and now I'm putting some stitches in, just closing things up. And that basically concludes the placement of these two implants. Thanks, guys. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment, and a thumbs up.
Overall drop in opioid use, and with the proper understanding and use of Exparel, you too can see the success that Exparel will bring to your clinic. Dr. McClelland, DDS, has been using it in his clinic for a few years now, and he's seen great success in his patients and their pain management every day. In this 6-video series, you get a professional masterclass that will give you the jumpstart you need to include Exparel in your daily routine. It includes a bonus PDF with a patient information handout, post-op medical instructions, and a quick look sheet for the materials and supplies for explaining Exparel. Go to Teachable.com today and get educated on a non-opioid anesthetic that will help your patients have a better day.